Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this week's edition of Horses and Courses in our 33rd year. And boy, one of the greatest performances in the history of HNC we'll have later on in the program. We're going to kick it off down at Gulfstream Park. Three-year-old fillies in the Any Limit.
They're in the gate. And they're off in the Any Limit Stakes. Who's the Lady gets the first call out the rail. Moving up the challenge is Faith and Hope. She'll land second behind Who's the Lady. Out third is Mia. Away racing in fourth while on hold is Fashion Runaway. Then it's a length and a half to Color and Colonel ahead of Cursor. And Truge is seventh and last at about 4.5 lengths off the lead of Who's the Lady. Who's the Lady and Paco Lopez to the half mile pole in front with Faith and Hope at the inside second. Mia third, Color and Colonel fourth. Down at the inside, Fashion Runaway is now fifth. And Cursor, she's second last while only 3 lengths off the lead, and Truge is the trailer as they round the far turn. 3/8 of a mile away, the opening quarter was very ordinary, 23-4. Who's the Lady? Lulling them to sleep up front, leads by a neck. Paco takes a peek over his shoulder. Mia's alongside second. Fashion Runaway is third. Cursor starting to warm to the task while looking for racing room. Ortiz splits horses while 4 wide as they turn in. Who's the Lady? Shaking up for the drive, 47-3 for the opening half mile. She should have plenty left, and indeed she does. Who's the Lady by 3. Cursor trying to track her down late. Who's the Lady? Cursor getting to her. Fashion Runaway between them. Who's the Lady has won it. Who's the Lady wins the Any Limit by a half a length in the end. Cursor second, Fashion Runaway third, then Faith and Hope and Truge in 1-12-1.
And there are the choices in reverse order. Who's the Lady? Paco Lopez goes to the front, wins by 3/4 for Kathleen O'Connell, returning $5.20. The even money favorite Cursor finishes second, and long shot at 20-1, Fashion Runway finishes third. Up next, older horses in the Skipaway.
They're in the gate. And they're off in the 30th running of the Skipaway Stakes. Good start for the gray, Flashy Jewel, who's offensive-minded. Zulu put in tight between horses and team colors is 3 wide as they run into the first turn. High Riverside will set up shop from fourth ahead of Fear the Cowboy, and long shot Joshua's Comprise is last of all as Flashy Jewel clears by a length and a half. Zulu is taken in hand to race in second, team colors on the outside third. High Riverside down at the inside races fourth, about 4.5 lengths off the pace setter, and the two at the back are Fear the Cowboy and Joshua's Comprise. They roll into the backstretch, and Joe Bravo and Flashy Jewel are aggressive today. They lead it by 2 through the opening quarter in 23-4. Team Colors is on a long rein, second. Zulu is third. Then it's the trio at the back, High Riverside, Joshua's Comprise, and Fear the Cowboy between horses for Jesus Rios. They're separated by 4 lengths in the run to the half-mile pole. Flashy Jewel went the opening half-mile in 48 seconds flat, but Bravo left the inside open. So here's how jockey Jose Ortiz on Zulu turning up the pressure second while down inside. Team Colors is now racing third. Racing on from fourth is Fear the Cowboy. Then High Riverside and Joshua's Comprise as they round the far turn. There was a brief bid from Zulu, but maintaining control is Flashy Jewel. Flashy Jewel past the 3-furlong point in front by a length after 3/4 in 1-12-2. Team Colors is second. Zulu is an all-in third to the outside and Fear the Cowboy. Then High Riverside with 1/4 mile left to go in the skip away. It's the big gray Flashy Jewel trying to take him start to finish off the top of the turn on a 2-length lead. Fear the Cowboy swung into action by Jesus Rios on the outside. These two go on from Team Colors and Zulu. There's 1/8 mile to go. Joe Bravo pleading for 1 more furlong from Flashy Jewel, but Fear the Cowboy runs past, and Fear the Cowboy and Jesus Rios are getting away. Give it to Fear the Cowboy in the skip away. He won it by 2.5. Zulu game for second, Flashy Jewel third, then High Riverside, Team Colors, and Joshua's Comprise in 151-4.
Fear the Cowboy scores the victory by 3 comfortable lengths as the third choice in the wagering, returning $9.20. Zulu, the even money favorite for Todd Pletcher, can do no better than second. Flashy Jewel finishes third. On Saturday afternoon, a terrific Chamber of Commerce day down in northern Kentucky. It was Spiral Day. Up first, the Rush Away.
They are off in the 30th running of the Rush Away, and they all came away in good order. Cool Arrow broke sharp right alongside Montu's Away in good order. Hey Mike stacks up third. Well, amazing. The undefeated horse is fourth, about a length and a half off the pace, and a separation of two to Hansa Nation away in the fifth position. Sailing Home is sixth, about five and a half off the lead, and a length in front of Gorgeous Kitten. And last away early, it's Capture the Glory. Midpoint through the opening turn, the first quarter, 23-2, and it's Montu who'll show him up the backstretch in front by about a length, Cool Arrow. The Springboard Mile winner races in second. Will Amazing stacks up three wide third. Down along the inside, Hey Mike is fourth, a length to Sailing Home, who's content to track in fifth up the backside, about five and a half lengths off the lead. He's a length and a half in front of Hansa Nation, and then Gorgeous Kitten being ridden along now with a half a mile still to go, and Capture the Glory can see them all. Up the backside to go, they pass the half in 47-2/5 seconds. It's still Montu, the long shot leader, but now Cool Arrow comes to tackle to the outside. These two are a length and a half in front of Hey Mike, who is third. There goes Will Amazing in fourth, Sailing Home being ridden hard to keep pace. Here comes Capture the Glory from last. The big long shot is moving well on the turn. Three quarters, 1:11-3, and they run to the top of the stretch, and Montu is still there. Cool Arrow, the whip comes out as they straighten away for the stretch drive, and Montu off the turn with a 2.5-length lead. Capture the Glory tightening up on the Gorgeous Kitten there as they're in the final furlong. Montu, but here's the long shot, Capture the Glory lunging up to the outside. Gorgeous Kitten down toward the inside. They're in the final 16th. Montu shaking up and responding for Rodney, and Montu will win the 30th running of the rush away all the way up top in 144-4.
And on a day where long shots were on the menu all day, 17-1 over 70-1. Montu goes to the front. Rodney Prescott aboard, wins by a length and a quarter. The Offspring of Dialed In returns $36.20. And if my math is right, ladies and gentlemen, boy, a exacta of $915 might be the largest in the history of the rush away. Gorgeous Kitten finishes third. The 3-2 favorite, Sailing Home, finishes sixth. Time for the three-year-old fillies in the Bourbonette Oaks.
And they are off in the 35th running of the Grade 3 Bourbonette Oaks. And it's Delphinia from the middle shows the way. Jenna J will prompt the pace from the inside. I'm Lucky's Girl stacks up a three-wide third. Then in between horses, Dark Wings over Dubai had to check there in fourth. Gilded Lily Terrell outside in fifth. Then comes Awesome Boss in sixth. Up on the outside, Miss O'Hara is seventh. The Maiden Northwest Bourbon shuffled back into eighth. Fun races right alongside her in ninth. Two lengths further back to the stake winner, China Grove is 10th. And On Her Honor is 11th. And last of the 12, it is Awesome Boss. Up the backside they go, first quarter in 23-2/5 seconds. It's Delphinia shows the way, pressured by the big long shot, I'm Lucky's Girl. These two match strides past the 4.5 furlong marker. Gilded Lily has moved an ever closer third. She's 2.5 lengths off the lead. To her outside is Purely a Dream. Down along the inside, Jenna J comes next. Right up to the outside is Miss O'Hara. Dark's Wings over Dubai, trying to work her way off the rail. She's being pinned in by Fun and starting to run on from the back of the pack. Here comes the stake winner, China Grove, as they round the far turn, just about 5/16 of a mile from home. And there goes Purely a Dream cut loose. Purely a Dream outside the quarter pole in front by two. Here's Gilded Lily attacks to the outside. Dark Wings over Dubai goes out to the five path as they straighten away three quarters, 1:10-4, and they're on their way home. And Purely a Dream opening up by the eighth pole. She's in front by four. Gilded Lily in chase mode. Now Dark Wings over Dubai dives down towards the inside, but in the final 16th, Purely a Dream drawing the way in the Bourbonette. And Purely a Dream has a May 5th date in Louisville. She wins the Bourbonette by two in the end. Stablemate Awesome Boss was second. Dark Wings over Dubai third. Gilded Lily was fourth. Running time 1:37-2.
Ken McPeak, Robbie Alvarado, the upset victory here. The Offspring of Pure Prize wins by two. Purely a Dream returns $27.60. Awesome Boss finishes second. Dark Wings over Dubai finishes third. Delphina, the 9-5 favorite, beats one horse, finishing 11th. And now annually the biggest race out at Turfway Park, three-year-olds in the Spiral.
They are off in the 46th running of the Jack Cincinnati Casino Spiral Stakes. And it's In Hands, who broke sharp from that 12 gate, and before they hit the finish line, he's worked his way all the way to the rail. So they pass the line for the first time. In Hands shows the way up top to the outside. Parlor, close up today, races along in the second position. Down along the inside, Fast and Accurate is third. Colonel Sampson is fourth. Shuffled back between horses, Giant Payday comes next. Out wide is Bronson. Then a length for the back, Kitten's Cat. Racing mid-pack, 10 lengths off the lead. A length in front of Blue Ridge Traveler. Separation of two. Back to Solio and King and His Court. The first quarter, they got it in 23-1, and they straighten up for the backstretch in the spiral. It's In Hands, shows the way up top by a length. Parlor, racing in the middle of the track, is second. Fast and Accurate, the other Hanson trainee, races third. Four lengths further back, Convict Pike is fourth. A length in front of Colonel Sampson in the Peak Silks is about six lengths off the lead. There goes Bronson, making that middle move is next. Separation of four. Kitten's Cat has 10 lengths to find. A length in front of Giant Payday, and starting to roll along the rail comes Blue Ridge Traveler. As they make their entrance into the turn, they got the half in 46-1. In Hands, still on a clear lead, shows them by a length and a half. Stablemate, Fast and Accurate, comes to the outside. Convict Pike moving well along the rail in third. Giant Payday, there's Parlor as they run past the quarter pole. It's In Hands, floats well off the rail. Fast and Accurate takes the lead as they turn for home in the 46th renewal of the Spiral Stakes. And it's Fast and Accurate who has the lead by a length and a half. Through from between horses, Convict Pike is gaining. And down the center, here comes Kitten's Cat. They have a 16th of a mile still to go. Fast and Accurate still up top. Convict Pike lunging to the inside. Kitten's Cat to the outside. Blue Lids Traveler along the rail. Fast and Accurate wins the Spiral Stakes by almost a length. Blue Ridge Traveler along the inside was second. A host of others, it's third, 150-4.
Boy, folks, favorites have had trouble in this race almost for a straight generation. Fast and Accurate makes it another long shot winner. How about these prices for your trifecta? 24-1, 35-1, 10-1. The $2 trifecta comes back $5,600+. Tyler Gaffleone, his first trip down to Turfway, Fast and Accurate. Mike Maker wins it again. The offspring of Hanson returns Dick Butkus numbers here, folks. $51 even. Blue Ridge Traveler finishes second. Convict Pike finishes third. The 5-2 favorite, Kitten's Cat, finishes fourth. Take a quick break. When we come back, Oaklawn Park and Sunland.
Now get all the racing information you need right on your mobile device with Capital OTV's new mobile app. Wager anytime, anywhere, right from your smartphone or tablet. Get up-to-the-minute scratches and race results. Watch our morning TV shows. Check out the Handicapper's Report. Find a branch or easy bet location and be up-to-date on all our latest promotions. It's everything you need to watch, wager, and win right at your fingertips. The new Capital OTV mobile app. Download it free from the iTunes Store or Google Play. In a recent study of some of the top online wagering sites, Capital OTB won big in total player rewards, far surpassing some of the best-known wagering sites in America. While other rewards programs simply offer you points redeemable for gift cards, Capital OTB's rebates are paid to you in actual cash. Plus, Capital OTB gives you full and immediate access to your money. So if all you're getting now are points and gift cards, join Capital OTB Player Rewards today and get cash back. Visit CapitalOTBBet.com and sign up today.
Hey, we've got a new show.
We do.
Absolutely, And They're Off, right here on the OTV TV network Sunday morning.
What's it all about?
It'll be a lot of fun. Fast-paced, plenty of topics, guests, handicapping, commentary, and maybe some opinions.
I have opinions on my opinions.
And we will have plenty of them because you're on the show. And They're Off, Sunday mornings here on the OTV TV network, 10 a.m. each Sunday. Should be a lot of fun. Anthony Mormino, Seth Merrill, we'll see you there.
I'm sorry, I went... Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turn our attention to Hot Springs, Arkansas, Saturday afternoon. The Purple Martin.
They're off. Country Candy wins the break, goes for the front from Our Majesty, who splits horses, and there goes Our Majesty and Vertical Oak to challenge Country Candy. Chanel's Legacy comes away running in fourth. Then comes Golden Mischief and at the rail with... at the rail whistle stop, and the trailer up the backstretch is Hot Shot Anna, and the leader is Our Majesty. Our Majesty is just in front of Country Candy in second. Chanel's Legacy has moved up smartly into third, and here's Chanel's Legacy within a length of the lead, now within a neck of the lead. Hot Shot Anna is running four deep, and these four are right across the track. Vertical Oak and Golden Mischief are fifth and sixth. Golden Mischief going to be five wide if she wins it. Whistle Stop is the trailer, and they run towards the top of the stretch. It is still Our Majesty narrowly in front. Chanel's Legacy is alongside. Hot Shot Anna, Golden Mischief finds a seam and is going to try to squeeze through a very tight spot, and she's up in there. And it is Our Majesty in front. Chanel's Legacy, Golden Mischief to the outside. Our Majesty or Golden Mischief going to be close. Our Majesty, Golden Mischief, Our Majesty. Our Majesty beat Golden Mischief and won the 15th Purple Martin.
Disqualification in here. Our Majesty taken down as the 8-5 favorite and placed fourth, elevating Golden Mischief to the victory as the second choice in the wagering. Ron Moquette sent out the offspring of Into Mischief, returned $7.40. Chanel's Legacy elevated to second. Vertical Oak placed third in the Purple Martin. All right, time to go out to New Mexico, their annual big day four from Sunday afternoon. Up first, the Bill Thomas Memorial.
And they're off. A good break. And best away is Taze on Ice, came out sharply with the lead. On the outside, Rockport Cat up the rails, Redneck Humors run past them and dashed out in front. Handy is Indexical, they're three clear from Quixote, Real Heaters back second last. And the early trailer is Mount Vita. That is the running order. Redneck Humor, the defending champion, clears them nicely and is going along with a nice cushion here. Two lengths in front of Taze on Ice, Indexical. On the outside, Rockport Cat, three wide, is pushed along a little bit. A length and a half, Quixote. On the inside, Real Heat, and the trailer is Mount Vita. About eight lengths covers them as they go into the turn, and Redneck Humor off the inside. A length and a half, Indexical, and Taze on Ice. Rockport Cat stays there, and they've got away again by three lengths to Quixote, Real Heat, and Mount Vita. Up the inside, Indexical after Redneck Humor. Redneck Humor by over a length and a half now, Indexical, Taze on Ice. On the outside, Rockport Cat not finding much at the moment. Quixote is needing to get a move on. Redneck Humor turns in the lead. On the inside, Indexical, the center is still Taze on Ice. Quixote running on in Real Heat. Redneck Humor in front. Indexical trying to peg the leader back, but it is Redneck Humor sailing on to what looks to be a back-to-back defending champion of the Bill Thomas Memorial. And no doubt about the best, Redneck Humor by four lengths, Indexical and Real Heat. And then Quixote.
Redneck Humor, the 3-2 favorite for Justin Evans, goes to the front, wins by 3 3/4, returning $5 even. Indexical finishes second. Real Heat finishes third. Up next, three-year-old fillies in the Sunland Park Oaks.
On their way, Best Away, Noted and Quoted, came out very swiftly on the inside. A good beginning for Soft Cheese, who's rushed up on the outside, and between them goes Mackenzie Honey. Right on the thick of the pace, Kettle Paso and What. And they got away at a scorching tempo. They're three in front of Galia, and Conquest Slayer is last. Soft Cheese throwing everything at the leader, Noted and Quoted, and takes over. Soft Cheese by a half to Noted and Quoted. Right behind them, Kettle Paso, What. A length to Mackenzie Honey. Galia's had a nice trip, and Speed to Target is moving up. And a long last is Conquest Slayer. They are really running at a fast pace in the Oaks here. And Soft Cheese is extended in front, tackled by Kettle Paso, Noted and Quoted on the inside, and nudging into it, What. Galia, a great setup, if good enough, is running into it beautifully. And then Mackenzie Honey and seven away last, Conquest Slayer. They go towards the half mile and out in front, Soft Cheese, tackled by Kettle Paso, Noted and Quoted as third, What on the outside. Galia tacks on and is running past Noted and Quoted, who's dropping out. And in behind the Mackenzie Honey and last, Conquest Slayer, the new leader, Kettle Paso. What challenging. And now Galia is just a length behind them. Soft Cheese is starting to drop off, and Conquest Slayer's running on. They go to the quarter. Kettle Paso and What. They battle this one out. In third, Galia is really hard ridden. Jose Ortiz getting something out of Galia now. What on the outside, Kettle Paso, the rail. Kettle Paso turns better. What in second, and now Galia reining them in with every stride. And Jose Ortiz played this one to the perfect copybook. Galia's hit the front. Kelpasso fighting tooth and nail. It's not over yet. Galia Kelpasso, but Galia's done the job. Galia wins the Oaks. Kelpasso gallant in defeat. A long gap. What? Then Conquest Slayer.
Todd Pletcher finds his way out to New Mexico and sends out the third choice in the wagering with Jose Ortiz in the saddle. The offspring of Medallia d'Oro wins the photo finish, returning $6 even over the co-favorite, not the actual betting favorite. Kelpasso finishes second. What? Finishes third. Noted and quoted, the 9-5 betting favorite finishes last. Up next, named after the famous announcer, the Harry Henson.
Locked up. And they're off. And a bump to Cancer Diva from Pibby Miller. Running out in front, African Rose. And on the inside, Danza Trees and Florent Giroux with a game plan here. Danza Trees quickly in the lead, up the inside. And coming around off the rail is Cancer Diva. African Rose the outside as Danza Trees slows the tempo now. That group of three by a length and a half to Warren's Puppy Love Bright Town. On the inside now, Conquest Arturo found room up the rail from Perfecta KP Wildcat. Pepe Miller's dropped four behind. Racing down the backstretch, Danza Trees joined by Katza Diva, who's gone up vigorously. And Danza Trees still traveling smoothly on their outside, African Rose. And they're clear, three to Warren's Puppy Love making ground. Then Bright Town. KP Wildcat spots the leader six lengths and is running on well. Behind them is Perfecta. Conquest Artura laboring. On the outside, Pepe Miller starts a run at the half mile. Danza Trees a half, Katza Diva, African Rose. She's coming at them on the outside nicely. And they got away about three or four lengths. On the inside is Warren's Puppy Love, Bright Town, and KP Wildcat. Katza Diva's grabbed Danza Trees, but she has to contend with the three-time winner of this race, African Rose, and African Rose has hit the front. African Rose at the quarter, a neck to Katza Diva. KP Wildcat's run into third down the lane, and these two have been hard ridden all the way, and KP Wildcat has a chance to run them down here. Out in front, Katza Diva, African Rose, KP Wildcat on the inside, and then came Pepe Miller from the back. African Rose in front with Katza Diva, KP Wildcat, and here's Pepe Miller from last. KP Wildcat hit the front, and KP Wildcat on the inside is the winner. A half a length, Katza Diva, African Rose, and Pepe Miller.
KP Wildcat scores the victory as the second choice in the wagering, turning $7 even for the half-length victory. Katza Diva finishes second. African Rose finishes third. The 9-5 favorite, Danza Trice, beats One Horse, finishing eighth. Up next, three-year-olds in the Sunderland Derby.
Away in racing, Bronze Age dipped quite dramatically at the start. Quickly gathered up, though, by Martin Garcia, and is up sharing the lead with Dilettante, and coming through nicely between horses is Hedge Fund up the inside and IRAP the center, and on their outside, Ballandine and Conquest More Money tacks on nicely up the rail. Shareholder Value in Oxford Lane as they turn out the stretch from Total Tap. And back behind them early, Wine and Divine and Hence, but only seven lengths covers the field, and it is Jose Ortiz and Hedge Fund, three parts to Bronze Age, a length and a half IRAP, three wide Ballandine, Shareholder Value saving every inch of ground on the inside, a beautiful position. Conquest More Money just two behind them, and then Dilettante on the inside Oxford Lane, followed by Total Tap. Three and a half to Hence is second last, and Wine and Divine is last. Racing in front, Hedge Fund trying to go gate to wire. By a length to Bronze Age, IRAP, and on the outside, Ballandine, Shareholder Value nursed along. In the center, Dilettante moving up. Conquest More Money is on the outside, and Total Tap joining in. Up the rails goes Oxford Lane. The leader's got away, Hedge Fund. Behind them, Hence is running on. Bronze Age is dropped right out of the race. And last is Wine and Divine. Three furlongs to run in the Derby. And it's Hedge Fund in front. But here comes Conquest. Mo Money has ranged up in second. IRAP is third. Hence let loose on the outside. Conquest, More Money's gone to the lead. Tackled by Hence in third, Hedge Fund. Then IRAP on the outside, Total Tap. And turning, Conquest, More Money in front. On the outside, Hence. And Hence has hit the lead. Hence in the lead. Conquest, More Money on the inside, fighting right back. And they will decide it. IRAP back in third. On the outside, Hence, a neck in front. Conquest, More Money can't bridge the gap. Hence in the lead's drawing off. And thus, Hence is going to win. And how impressive, Hence. By four lengths, Conquest More Money, Hedge Fund third, then IRAP, and Total Tap.
Very impressive performance for the Calumet runner. Steve Asmussen sent out Hence to win by 3 3/4, who looked so powerful at 10-1 in the stretch. The offspring, a street boss out of an AP Indy mare, returns $23.60. Conquest, Mo Money finishes second. Hedge Fund finishes third. The 5-2 favorite, Bronze Age, who stumbled badly at the start, finishes last as the chalk. We take a quick break. When we come back, stakes action from Santa Anita and the Big A.
Hey, race fans, head down to the all-new Clubhouse Racebook and get in the game. With live horse racing on more than 250 flat-screen TVs, state-of-the-art wagering terminals, fantastic food and drinks, an amazing Vegas-style atmosphere with seating for nearly 900 of your closest friends. Conveniently located at 711 Central Avenue, right off Exit 5 of I-90 in Albany, the Clubhouse Racebook is the better choice.
Not at the track and not near a computer? No problem. Wager with Capital OTB's Touchstone Wagering System and you'll never get shut out again. Capital OTB's Touchstone Wagering System is quick, simple to use, and guarantees your wagers are accurate and placed on time. For more information, visit CapitalOTB.com or call Capital OTB's customer service hotline at 800-292-BETS. Capital OTB's Touchstone Wagering System. Never get shut out again.
No matter where in the world you are, the excitement of wagering on horse racing is just a click away. CapitalOTB.com offers live streaming, past performances, race replays, our virtual tote board, analysis and selections from professional handicappers, and a simple, safe, and secure wagering platform. And best of all, you get track prices. Going on now, it's Bet 50, Get 50. Simply open a Capital Bets account, bet $50, and get $50 cash back. CapitalOTB.com. Log on today.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turning attention to Arcadia, California, and Santa Anita, part of their series on the turf, the San Luis Rey.
Racing. Ashley Love Sugar wins the start. Papa Cool, going fast with It's in the Post Inordinate. Next from Powerfoot and Flamboyant Syntax. They're followed by Some in TMA, Texas Rayano around Buster Douglas. Ashley Love Sugar is just in the front from Papa Cool, Inordinate, It's in the Post. Followed fifth by Powerfoot. Next is Flamboyant, five lengths off the lead. Syntax three wide. Liam the Charmer midfield on the inside from Some in TMA, Buster Douglas. Texas Rayano's a long way back with Sight Read. Over the dirt crossing, and Ashley Love Sugar is the leader. Moves out by two lengths to Papa Cool, Inordinate. It's in the Post. Followed after two lengths by Powerfoot. Liam the Charmer midfield on the fence. Flamboyant is three wide in the black cap, seven lengths off the leader. Then Syntax, Buster Douglas, Some in TMA, and two lengths to Texas Rayano with Sight Read. It's Ashley Love Sugar doing the honors. He's in front, pricking the ears as he passes the judges. A lap to go by three quarters of a length. It's in the Post. Three lengths away, third is Inordinate, followed closely by Papa Cool. And back in fifth, Flamboyant. He's still out three wide. Liam the Charmer along the fence. Powerfoot splits horses with six furlongs to go. A length and a half to Syntax on the inside, followed by Some in TMA. And then Sight Read, Texas Rayano. Buster Douglas has dropped out four lengths last. Into the back stretch at the 5/8 pole. And Ashley Love Sugar from It's in the Post. They've raced six lengths clear from Inordinate, Papa Cool, Liam the Charmer, Powerfoot, Flamboyant next from Syntax and Some in TMA. Sight Read on the outside of Texas Rayano and Buster Douglas last of all. Less than a half mile to go. The field has strung out over 25 lengths. It's Ashley Love Sugar one in the front. It's in the Post as second at the 3/8 pole. 2.5 lengths away, Liam the Charmer third. Inordinate working off the rail. Papa Cool, three wide. Syntax creeping along the fence from Flamboyant. Powerfoot is next, followed by Some in TMA. Texas Rayano a mile back. Turning for home, and Ashley Love Sugar has been headed by It's in the Post. They're two lengths in front of Syntax getting into the clear. And back forth is Liam the Charmer. Past the 8th pole, It's in the Post has the lead. Syntax trying to run him down. Ashley Love Sugar relegated to third. Liam the Charmer next. It's in the Post. Clings to the lead from Syntax. It's in the Post. It's in the Post for the San Luis Rey. 1 3/4 of a length. Syntax second. Third home, Ashley Love Sugar. Liam the Charmer next. And fifth would be among Inordinate, Texas Rayano, and Powerfoot.
It's in the Post. For Jeff Mullins and Tyler Bayes, they score the one-length victory at nearly 7-1, returning $15.60. At 27-1, Syntax finishes second. And the 6-5 favorite, Ashley Loves Sugar, finishes third in the San Luis Rey. Sunday afternoon, the Dream Summer.
Racing. Rose Valentine begins brilliantly, leads from Sky Diamonds, Top Notch now accelerating along the rail, Mizzen Glory running fourth outside of Time for Ebby, followed wider by Cuddle Alert. A bit further back is Sheer Pleasure, between runners, six lengths off the early pace, and the trailer is dressed to a T. Rose Valentine in front, a length and a half, Sky Diamonds in second, and Top Notch going back on the inside third. Then a three wide Mizzen Glory onto the back stretch, Cuddle Alerts out four wide, four lengths off the pace, Time for Ebby towards the rail, Sheer Pleasure between runners in a bunched field, two and a half lengths to the trailer, dressed to a T. Rose Valentine coming past the 5/8 pole on a one length lead from Sky Diamonds and Mizzen Glory. Glory, Cuddle Alert. Top Notch now fifth on the inside, attended closely by Sheer Pleasure, with a couple of lengths to dress to a T, joining Time for Ebby. Along to the half-mile pole, and it's Rose Valentine, one length to Mizzen Glory. Sky Diamonds the inside, Top Notch is a length and a half off fourth. Cuddle Alert still wide. Sheer Pleasure continues to split horses with four lengths to pick up. Dress to a T, second last in her dirt debut, and the trailer now is Time for Ebby. 5/16 to go, and Pedroza sneaking away on Rose Valentine, leading more than two lengths to Sky Diamonds. A length and a half to Top Notch on the inside from Mizzen Glory, followed into the stretch by Sheer Pleasure, who comes through now to third, has five lengths to pick up upon swinging for home. Less than 3/16 to go, and Sky Diamonds puts the acid test to Rose Valentine, goes straight past the early leader and kicks to a one-length lead. They're a long way clear of the rest, dressed to a T, and Sheer Pleasure boxing home okay, but Sky Diamonds in front. Sky Diamonds takes the Dream of Summer from Rose Valentine, seven lengths clear of dressed to a T, and Sheer Pleasure finished fourth.
In Southern California, Dream Summers commence about April 15th, but Sky Diamonds, the 4-5 favorite for Bill Spar, scores the 1 1/4 length official victory, returning $3.60. Rose Valentine finishes second. Dressed to a T finished third. Headed back for closing weekend on the inner dirt track at the Big A. A couple scratches in here left us with just three in the Cicada.
And they're off. Heavenly Score and Bluegrass Flag break out on top. Tiz Rayana pulls back to be third in the early going, but it will be Bluegrass Flag out to set the pace on the far outside. Leads by 3/4 length. Heavenly Score broke near the top, but is content back in second. And Tiz Rayana moves to the outside to be third. Heading up the backstretch, Bluegrass Flag makes the lead fairly easily and opens up about a length and a half with a half mile to go. Tiz Rayana is advancing on the outside of Heavenly Score. They're sharing second and third as they move on to the far turn. Bluegrass Flag's opening quarter was 23-3. There's an opening down inside for Heavenly Score, and she comes down through to put in a challenge midway around the far turn. Tiz Rayana is 3 lengths farther back in third now. Racing for the top of the stretch, Bluegrass Flag fending off the challenge of Heavenly Score, opens back up off the turn, and just like that is clear by two. Top of the stretch now, Bluegrass Flag in front, the whip is out. Heavenly Score, the whip is out as well, but she is second, 2.5 lengths behind. Tiz Rayana's third, there's 1 furlong to go, and Bluegrass Flag has put them all away. Opening up by 3, now by 4, now by 5. Bluegrass Flag romps in the Cicada, winning by 6 lengths in the end. Heavenly Score was second, Tiz Rayana was third.
And when the scratches were done and the betting finished up, Bluegrass Flag for Tom Morley and Kendrick Carmouche was the 1-5 favorite. They win by 6. The New York Red returns $2.60. Heavenly Score finishes second. Tiz Rayana finishes third in this year's Cicada. We're up to our final break. When we come back, Dubai World Cup night.
Come on.
I want sales reports on my desk by Monday.
Whoops. My bad.
Love racing? RTN brings you every live simulcast on your home television, plus live video streaming and race replays on your PC and mobile devices. To order, visit rtn.tv. RTN, a breed apart.
24 hours a day, 7 days a week, OTB TV is the Capital Region's choice for the most comprehensive and informative coverage of thoroughbred and harness racing. OTB TV is the only area network delivering a steady viewership, reaching more than 540,000 households throughout the broadcast day and into the evening. Capital OTB's digital presence also plays a tremendous part in getting your message in front of potential customers. With more and more wagering moving to online, CapitalOTB.com can put your message in front of thousands of potential customers 24 hours a day. And with the addition of our new mobile app, new customers will see your message on all their digital devices. To see how affordably you can reach thousands of new customers, contact Capital OTB's sales and marketing department today. You're
unbelievable. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Seven races to bring you from Maidan. $28 million in purses. Up first, the Godolphin Mile.
Gates fly, they're racing in the Godolphin Mile, and second Summer and Farrier were both slow to move. Triple Nine dropped back shortly after the break. Heavy Metal came out very quickly. North America began well. Gifted Master fast away, and that trio were jousting for the lead. North America in front onto the course proper, 1,200 metres out. Gifted Master holds the inside. Heavy Metal, a neck away running third, and Sharp Azteca is a neck away running fourth, and he's out four wide with 1,100 metres left to travel. A break of 3.5 lengths to Etta Jar, one to Ross on the inside of Storm Adele, and then one to Farrier on the inside of La Bernardine. 3/4 of a length to Fitzgerald, a length and a half Kafuji Taka. Second Summer is second last, and Triple Nines a length and a half away at the tail of the field as they left the first quarter behind in 23.2.5 in 45.5. They're whizzing along, and Sharp Azteca out deep on the track had gone up to tackle Heavy Metal. North America on the rail being ridden along. Gifted Master flying the white flag. Ross to the outside with the American. Sharp Azteca took over past the quarter pole, bounded two lengths in front. Ross running into second spot is giving chase. Second Summer's come from a mile back to move to third, and then Farrier, Sharp Azteca in front. Second Summer is coming after him. He went back to the inside. Sharp Azteca, Second Summer, Ross on the outside, three of them. Second Summer and Ross, Second Summer, Second Summer. Watson's done it again. A Godolphin Mile to Red Stable. Second Summer has won from Ross and Sharp Azteca, and they drew well clear of Fitzgerald.
Second Summer, our first but not our last horse to be in 13th place at the first call, scores the victory with Pat Dobbs in the saddle. Ross finishes second. Sharp Azteca, not quite sharp enough, finishes third in the Godolphin Mile. Up next, three-year-olds in the Grade 2 UAE Derby.
As the button, racing in the Derby, four-ree jump with them. Lancaster Bomber, Spirit of Valor, he runs away, dropped back shortly after the break. Adorato out wide, and Epicharis in the center came out quickly. Guitar Man began well. He's trying to hold the fence as they charge into the first turn near the 1600 meters mark, and he has held the plastic Guitar Man. Epicharis goes up to eyeball him, and Adorato is a length away running third. Four resettles fourth, Midnight Chicka fifth on the inside of Thunder Snow. Cosmo Charlie deep turning into the back, B Jersey midfield. A length and a half for Tory Kin on the outside of Master Plan. One to Spirit of Valor, a half Lancaster Bomber, followed by Fly at Dawn, No More Rich Blondes. He runs away his second last, and top score is three lengths back at the tail of the field. Epicharis pressed on. He wanted to lead, and with 900 metres left to run, he's 3/4 of a length in front. They left the first half behind in 48.2. Epicharis showed the Derby field the way to the back. by 3/4 of a length over Adorato. Thunder Snow's 3/4 of a length away. He's edging up to be third now. Guitar Man fourth. Forey fifth being ridden along. Then Vittori Kid, Master Plan, is being asked to improve. And then Lancaster Bomber, Spirit of Valor, Fly at Dawn and a break. He runs away at the head of the others. Coming around the turn, Thunder Snow moved up to Epicharis. 400 metres left to run. Two lengths away, Guitar Man. Then Lancaster Bomber. It's Thunder Snow alongside Epicharis. Thunder Snow, the Guineas winner. Epicharis from Japan, 200 metres out. Thunder Snow's running about. Epicharis battling back. Epicharis in front. Thunder Snow trying to raise another effort. Epicharis in front. Thunder Snow lunges again. And I think one in the last possible gasp. Thunder Snow in a photo in the Derby from Epicharis. Master Plan's run third. Lancaster Bomber fourth.
Very exciting stretch run here. I thought the winner and the runner-up each put in about two moves. And Thunder Snow with Christophe Suleiman in the saddle has the last slightly better move to score the victory for the home team. Epicharis finishes second. Master Plan finishes third. Up next, the Elgaz.
They're racing in the Elgaz. Amazing Kids near the inside, one of the first away. Medician Man came out quickly. Baccarat and Lamato out wide jump with them, but not showing the speed of the leaders in the early part. Where Final Venture burns to the front from Medician Man. Ertegel, the right man, Jungle Cat. Richard's Boy, the grey, coming down the outside, being tagged by Lamato. Baccarat is the widest runner. Amazing Kids going in behind the pace with Finsbury Square. Then Washington DC and Long on Value had dropped out to the tail of the field. Ertegel had taken the lead. They're on the course proper. 500 metres left to go. Ertegel from Richard's Boy. Final Venture on the far side. Then the right man. Lamato's under pressure. Baccarat is deeper out. Jungle Cat's under pressure. Ertegel in front. 300 metres left to go. Tackled by the right man. Richard's Boy, Long on Value, running on. The right man got through. The right man hit the lead, 100 to go. Long on Value is sweeping down the outside. The right man in front, Long on Value, lunged photo. The right man and Long on Value, one for the judge, a thriller in the Elgaz. Ertegel third, Jungle Cat fourth, and Richard.
The right man, quick enough and right enough, scores the victory in here. Long on Value finishes second. Ertegel finishes third as the pace setter. Up next, one of the premier dirt sprints annually in the world, the Dubai Golden Shaheen.
They're ready. Gates fly. They're racing in the Golden Shaheen, and Morrowidge from the inside, one of the first out. My Catch began well. St. Joe Bay came out running. Muarab's just behind the pace, then High on Life. Dundonald, Stalwalk and Dude, Renato the Wizard, followed by Dios Carita, Cool Cowboy, back off the pace. Comacass is out very deep as they charge into the first bend, and Wild Dude dropped out to be last of all. My Catch the leader, 700 metres out, leaving a quarter behind at 23.9. St. Joe Bay went up to be second, Morrowidge third, Muarab is ahead away, running fourth, and then High on Life, Ranello the winner, Comacass, Stalwalk and Dude. Further back is Mind Your Biscuits out very deep as heads are turned for home. My Catch, tackled by St. Joe Bay. 300 metres out, Morrowidge coming around their heels. Comacass down the outside. And Mind Your Biscuits is storming right down the centre of the track. Here comes Biscuits. Mind Your Biscuits storm to the front 100 metres out from Comacass. And Mind Your Biscuits raced away to win the Dubai Golden Shaheen. Photo for the miners.
And in a powerful, very powerful late stretch run by Joel Rosario and Mind Your Biscuits. And I do like, even on a serious night as Dubai World Cup night, here comes Biscuits, I thought was very funny. But Mind Your Biscuits scores the victory. Comacas finishes second. Morrowidge finishes third. Up next, over back to the turf, the Dubai turf.
Gates are back. They're racing in the Dubai turf, and the starter caught them to a great line. Dovi out wide, the first to split it, but he won't stay in front. Very special, Opal Tiara. Ripchester going forward, Mudakayev and Zarak are not far off the pace as they charge onto the first bend. Then Dovi, followed by Decorated Knight on the inside of Mondia List. Hisham goes up onto the rail, a length away Long Island Sound on the outside of Viv Loss. 2.5 to Debt Collector, and Cougar Mountain had dropped out to be last of all, a length off the second last horse as Ripchester hold the rail. Going past the 1200 metres mark, and Ripchester showed the way by a neck, leaving a quarter behind in 26.3. Ripchester joined on the outside by Very Special, who goes looking for the front. Mudakayev is third, two lengths off the pace. Zarak is fourth on the rail. A length away then is Dovi on the outside of Opal Tiara in the middle. Hisham on the fence, three quarters of a length Mondia List. Decorated Knights on the rail, followed by Long Island Sound, Viv Loss. Debt Collector second last, and Cougar Mountain against the plastic last of all. The mare's the leader. They're on the bend for home, 550 metres out. Very Special showed the way. Ripchester came off the fence. Mudakayev is three deep. Zarak, two lengths off the pace behind them. Dovi to the outside. Hisham is wending his way through. Ripchester hit the front. Mudakayev going after him. Zarak back to the inside, but Hisham's the one. Hisham with 200 metres left to go. Raced up to Ripchester. Here's Viv Loss for Japan. Zooming down the outside. Viv Loss finishing with a withering run. And Viv Loss has won the Dubai Turf from Hisham and Ripchester. Zarak fourth. Mudakayev has run fifth, and then Decorated Knight.
Viv Loss scores the victory in here. Coming from way back early, Hisham finishes second. Ripchester, the pace setter, holds on to run third in the Dubai Turf. All right, now the marathon turf race in the Dubai Shima Classic.
Gates are back racing in Longines Dubai Shima Classic, and Seventh Heaven was slow to move, immediately hooked back to the tail of the field. Highland Reel came out well and went straight to the lead with Jack Hobbs second. Postponed deep in front of Prize Money, Sounds of Earth, Earnshaw. Pushing up on the rail, and Seventh Heaven is a length and a half away as they swing out of the straight with short of 2,100 metres left to run. Highland Reel steers them towards the back of the track. Leads by a little more than a length. Postponed is second. Jack Hobbs a half length away third. A length and a half to Sounds of Earth, a half to Prize Money on the rail. A length to Seventh Heaven, and Earnshaw has now been shuffled back to be last of all as they turn into the back of the track. Short of 1,600 metres left to run. First quarter left behind in a leisurely 28.7 on the rain affected going. And it's Highland Reel showing the way down the back of the track. Leading by a touch more than a length. Postponed, keeping the leader in his sights, and they're away from the rail. Jack Hobbs, a neck away running third. 2.5 lengths to Sounds of Earth on the outside of Prize Money. Another length and a half then to Seventh Heaven, and three quarters of a length to Earnshaw. That's the order in the Dubai Shima Classic as they work down the back of the track, and Highland Reel continues to show the way. They're out in the middle of the course as they head towards the back bend, and it's Highland Reel leading by a neat length. Postponed is second. 1,000 metres left to run. Jack Hobbs third, a length and a half off the pace. Then one to Sounds of Earth, who's taking closer order on the outside of Prize Money. Three quarters of a length to Seventh Heaven, and a half length away is Earnshaw. There's been little change in the order. They're travelling down the side, and still Highland Reel showed the way. Postponed is now sneaking up closer, going past the 600 metres peg. They're a length and a half in front of Prize Money, getting right up along the rail. Jack Hobbs on his outside as they fan coming around the corner. Then Sounds of Earth, Seventh Heaven, and Earnshaw. Jack Hobbs and Prize Money on the inside. Postponed the outside. They get past Highland Reel. Jack Hobbs hit the front. 250 metres out. Jack Hobbs in front of Prize Money. Seventh Heaven on the inside and then postponed. But Jack Hobbs with 100 metres left to go. Jack Hobbs has hit it out of the ground. Jack Hobbs wins the Dubai Shima Classic, beating Seventh Heaven, postponed Prize Money.
Only a field of seven in here, but a terrific, terrific effort. Godolphin gets their second winner on the night. William Buick for John Gosden. Jack Hobbs scores the victory. Seventh Heaven finishes second. And Postponed, who I, in my opinion, had no excuse, finishes third in the Dubai Shima Classic. All right, the time has come for one of the great moments in the history of this wonderful sport, the Dubai World Cup.
Ready. Shane Ryan has the button. Gats fly. They're racing in the Dubai World Cup, and Gold Dream slow to move, and Arrogant is last. At the end of the first 100 metres, Arrogate last as they charge down to the judge the first time. Long River has swept to the lead. Gun Runner is second past the judge, Neolithic third. Mugdahidge from the wide gate will slot in on the fence. He's fourth on the turnout of the straight. A length and a half for War D on the inside of Special Fighter. 2 lengths away, Apollo Kentucky. Furia Crusada deep, move up in the middle. A length to Gold Dream, a length to Opportunity. 1.5 to Arrogate, 2 lengths to Keen Ice, and Lani is 3 lengths away at the tail of the field. Long River takes them down the back of the track. 1,200 metres left to run. The first quarter in 24.8, and Long River showed the way, led by a half length. Gun Runner second. Neolithic 3/4 of a length away, third, and he's 3 wide. Mugdahidge is fourth. He's away from the fence. He's a length and a half off the pace. Gold Dream is deep. Awardee goes up on the rail, then Special Fighter. Opportunity and move up Apollo Kentucky. Arrogate's out wide now. He's being asked to improve, but he's still 8 lengths off the lead. Further back, Furia Crusada, Keen Ice, and Lani is a long last. Gunrunner has gone to the front. They've 550 metres left to run, and Gunrunner showed the way. Neolithic's a half length away second. 1.5 lengths to Mugdahidge, and here comes the big A. Arrogate on the outside. Gun Runner in front of Neolithic, but Arrogate swoops up on the outside. America's King Croesus of horse racing went to the front. 200 metres left to go. Arrogate has drawn away from Gun Runner. A is for Arrogate. A is for Absolute Superstar. A is for Anointing. Have we seen the anointing of the man of war of the 21st century? Arrogate, a brilliant winner of the Dubai World Cup from Gun Runner.
Boy, folks, about as good as it gets, because it was about as awful as it gets as the start. And I love the charts from Trackis for World Cup night. Arrogate's first quarter mile, 26-3. He put in a tremendous second quarter to get in contact with the field. I thought after starting 13th in the race, Mike Smith did a masterful job in here. And in the end, Gunner Runner ran terrifically. His final quarter mile was 24.73. But Arrogate, who had already put in a 23 and change quarter mile in the race, runs home 23.83 for the final quarter mile, something we're familiar with after the Traverse Stakes. Gun Runner, you know, just you ran against one of the greats of all time. Neolithic finishes third, but just a performance for the ages. Now, it should be noted, when you look at the dirt races on there, off the pace horses did well on World Cup night, but Arrogate just absolutely magnificent. Great job by Mike Smith. Also very, very wisely ridden after just a horrific, horrific start. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that wraps up this week's edition of HNC. Enjoy your stakes action from around the country, and join us next time for Horses and Courses.
You're watching OTB TV, a service of Capital Off Track Betting.